हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू पुलवास ईसेट एकेडमी ईसेट ईसीई 2021। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द सेमीकंडक्टर डायोड्स। इट इज द सेकंड टॉपिक इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस एंड सर्क्यूट्स। ओके, सो लेट मी राइट हियर सेमीकंडक्टर डायोड्स। As I was mentioning, this topic has a weightage of 2 to 3 marks in electronic devices and circuits. Okay, so what am I going to explain in this topic? Or I am going to discuss about mass action law. I am also going to discuss about types of currents in semiconductors, and we will see the formation of p-n junction. I will also discuss the diode circuits and the applications of diodes. Then we will see the special purpose diodes like varector diode and Zener diode and the applications of Zener diode. First, let me start with mass action law. So let me write here mass action law. So what is this mass action law is? Listen to me carefully. According to mass action law, the product of electron concentration and hole concentration is a constant at any given temperature. Let me repeat this again for you. According to mass action law, the product of electron concentration and hole concentration is a constant at any given temperature, and it is given by n multiplied by p is equal to ni square. So n is the electron concentration, p is the hole concentration, and this is the multiplication, which is equal to ni square. This is valid at any given temperature, where this ni is the intrinsic electron concentration. Okay, so how this ni is defined is ni square is equal to a naught into t cube e power minus eg by kt. So this is how ni is defined in the intrinsic semiconductors. So ni square is proportional to t cube. So that's how ni is going to increase with respect to the temperature. Okay. So let me consider intrinsic semiconductor. So I can prove this relation is valid in this intrinsic semiconductor by multiplying electron concentration and hole concentration. I have to prove this is equal to ni square. As you all know, in the intrinsic semiconductor, electron concentration is same as the hole concentration. Since pi is equal to ni, in intrinsic semiconductor, pi is equal to ni. Therefore, ni into ni is equal to ni square. So thereby, I can prove that LHS is equal to RHS. Okay, so this is valid in intrinsic semiconductor. So for example, let me take ni value as 4 and pi value as 4. Thereby, I can prove that ni into pi, which is equal to ni square. So 4 into 4 is equal to 16. This is for example I am considering. Okay. So the same relation I can prove in the extrinsic n-type semiconductor as well as in extrinsic p-type semiconductor. Okay, so let me do that for you. So let me consider n-type semiconductor. So if you are multiplying n into p, which is equal to ni square, so the n is the electron concentration and p is the hole concentration, which is equal to ni square. For example, as you know an n-type semiconductor, so the electron concentration is the majority carrier concentration and hole concentration is the minority carrier concentration, which means that n is far far greater than p in n-type semiconductor. So let me take n value as 8 and p value as 2 such that this relation is valid. Okay, so when you are multiplying these two, you will again get 16 as your answer. Okay, and this multiplication of electron concentration and hole concentration is equal to ni square. Okay, and if you are considering p-type semiconductor, so let me write here p-type semiconductor. In p-type semiconductor, you know p is the majority carrier concentration and n is the minority carrier concentration. So then when you are multiplying, n into p is equal to ni square. So again, for example, I am considering p value as 8 and n value as 2. Again, when you are multiplying these two, you will get as ni square. So which means that this mass action law is valid in any semiconductor, be it intrinsic semiconductor or extrinsic n-type semiconductor or extrinsic p-type semiconductor. This mass action law is well valid. Okay, so let me explain a point here. In n-type semiconductor, you might think that you are increasing the electron concentration, but you also have to think that hole concentration is decreased to the same amount such that this product remains constant always. And again, in the p-type semiconductor, you might be thinking that hole concentration is increased drastically, but you also have to think that thereby electron concentration is decreased to same amount. So when electron concentration is decreased and hole concentration is increased, this product remains constant always. So this product remains constant always. It can be any semiconductor at a given temperature. Okay, so it can be any semiconductor at a given temperature. The product of electron concentration and hole concentration remains constant. So let me solve a question for you. So in n-type semiconductor, given that intrinsic carrier concentration Ni is equal to 1.5 into 10 power 10 per centimeter cube. In n-type semiconductor, it is given that Ni is equal to 1.5 into 10 power 10 per centimeter cube. And also it is given that majority carrier concentration, so let me clearly write here, majority carrier concentration, which is N equal to 2.25 into 10 power 15 per centimeter cube. So then he is asking you to calculate minority carrier concentration, P. So you need to calculate P here. Okay, so you can use mass action law in order to calculate this P value. Okay, so options are given, so I am not mentioning here. You can directly calculate P and you can choose the right option. Okay, so how can you solve this? So you need to use mass action law, so where N into P is equal to Ni square. So this mass action law is very important. Be it any semiconductor, this mass action law is well valid. Okay, so already there is a given data. So what is the given data? He has given Ni, has also given N, he is asking you to calculate, so P. So if you are calculating P is equal to Ni square by N, then you will get, so N is 1.5 into 10 power 10 whole square by, what is N? 2.25 into 10 power 15. So thereby P value is 1 into 10 power 5 centimeter cube. So 1 into 10 power 5 centimeter cube is the value of P, and that is the correct answer. So in the options, you have to select this value of P. Okay. So now let me arrange this question. So let me explain this type of currents in a semiconductor with simple analogy. Suppose if I am considering a sweet box, okay, so let me consider a sweet box. Now we will discuss types of currents in semiconductor. So let me write here, types of currents in a semiconductor. Okay, so let me consider P-type semiconductor. So let me take P-type semiconductor here. This is P-type semiconductor. And as you all know, in P-type semiconductor, majority carriers are holes and minority carriers are electrons. So majority carriers are holes and minority carriers are electrons. Let me consider these holes in major number. Okay, so let me consider these holes in major number, and let me also consider electrons in less number. You can see here there are less number of electrons and there will be more number of holes. For the time being, or for the simplicity, let me neglect these electrons. Okay, it is just for the simplicity we are neglecting these electrons because they are less in number. So let me consider here plane of axis. So this is my plane of axis. Let's say this is plane 1 and this is plane 2. So when you are considering a semiconductor and when you are keeping a plane of axis and you are dividing it like plane 1 and plane 2, you can observe that number of holes moving from plane 1 to plane 2 will be the same as number of holes moving from plane 2 to 1. So that is what you can realize here. The number of holes moving from plane 1 to 2 will be the same as number of holes moving from plane 2 to 1. Because of holes movement, you can have a current. And this current and this current are exactly balanced and they are in the opposite direction. So thereby the net effective current is equal to 0 amperes. So the net current is equal to 0 amperes. This is where we will say that this semiconductor is under equilibrium. Okay. So in simple terms, I can say that when the semiconductor is in equilibrium, when the semiconductor is in equilibrium, the net current is equal to 0 amperes. What is the meaning of equilibrium condition? The meaning of equilibrium condition is as follows. If there is a process happening at some rate, there will be inverse process happening at the same rate. If suppose 10 holes are moving from plane 1 to 2 and at the same time 10 holes will be moving from plane 2 to 1. So that is what the equilibrium condition. When the semiconductor is under equilibrium, the net current is 0 amperes. So now what is the idea? We want to get current in the semiconductor. If you want to get current in the semiconductor, what all you have to do? We have to disturb this equilibrium condition. So So we have to disturb this equilibrium condition. How can you disturb this equilibrium condition is, in one way, how can you disturb this equilibrium condition is, we will apply electric field. So we will apply electric field in this direction, let's say. Again, we are considering p-type semiconductor. We are considering hole concentration here. Let me take now plane of axis. Okay. So now we are applying the electric field. When you are applying the electric field in this direction, holes will be moving in the same direction. If this is plane 1 and if this is plane 2, now you can realize that holes will only moving from plane 1 to plane 2. There is no further movement of holes from plane 2 to plane 1. What does it mean? It means that the net effective current is not at all 0 amperes. There is a current that is due to holes moving from 1 to 2 only. So such type of current, we will simply call it as drift current. So this is one type of current in semiconductor, and that is due to electric field. If you are applying electric field, the holes will only moving from 1 to 2. So this applied electric field is also resisting the movement of holes from 2 to 1. So thereby holes cannot move from 2 to 1 and holes can only move from 1 to 2. So thereby the net effective current is not at all 0, and that is drift current. Okay. So the other way of disturbing equilibrium condition is, this is second way of disturbing the equilibrium condition. So again, I am considering p-type semiconductor. So here what am I doing is, I am increasing the temperature at this end. At this end, I am keeping the temperature constant, but at this end, I am increasing the temperature. I am heating the semiconductor at this end only. I am not heating the semiconductor at this end. What is the condition I am considering here? T1 much greater than T2. So when you are heating the semiconductor at this end, thereby you are increasing the temperature here. By increasing the temperature, you are increasing the hole concentration here. Let's say P1 is becoming 100 and P2 is becoming 80. Initially, let's assume that the hole concentration at this end is 80 only, and the hole concentration at this end also 80 only. At this end, we are not changing the temperature, but at this end, we are changing the temperature, which means we are increasing the temperature, thereby hole concentration is increasing. Now the hole concentration is increased to 100 from 80. Now you can see that there is a change in carrier concentration. Here, higher number of holes, and here, lesser number of holes. So thereby, automatically, holes will be trying to move from higher concentration to lower concentration. Holes only moving from plane 1 to plane 2. Okay? Holes can move only from higher concentration to lower concentration. By creating carrier concentration difference, we are making holes to move from plane 1 to plane 2 only. So thereby, we have a net effective current, and that is diffusion current. Are you understanding? Clear? Okay. So drift effect is due to electric field, and diffusion effect is due to change in carrier concentration or carrier concentration difference. Now let me explain this type of currents or types of currents with a simple analogy. Analogy for types of currents. Okay, so let me consider a sweet box here. So the top of the sweet box is open. Okay. So the top of this sweet box is open. So there will be some flies above the sweet box, moving randomly. Okay. So here, what am I trying to do is, I am trying to completely shift the sweet box from here to here. So let me shift the sweet box from here to here. So thereby what happens, all these flies will be moving from here to here. So initially these flies are moving randomly. So when these are moving randomly, the net effect will be zero. Now what am I doing? I am superimposing a directed motion on these flies. I am making these flies to move from here to here. Yeah, what is this effect? Drift effect. So what we are doing in the first case, we are applying the electric field in the direction of plane 1 to 2. So thereby we are making the holes to move from plane 1 to 2. We are superimposing directed motion on the holes such that holes can move only from plane 1 to 2. Okay. So the next is same sweet box I am considering here. On the top of it, there are some flies moving randomly. I keep one more sweet box here. Okay. So this is sweet box 1 and one more sweet box I am keeping here. And I am assuming that there are no flies above the sweet box. It is just an assumption. There are no flies above the sweet box. Then what happens? Some of the flies will be moving from here to here. So higher concentration of flies, no concentration of flies. What happens? Flies will be moving from higher concentration to lower concentration. So this effect is called diffusion effect. So please understand, drift effect is due to applied electric field. Diffusion effect is due to change in carrier concentration or carrier concentration difference. Okay. So let me write some points about drift current and diffusion current. So I drift is due to electric field and I diffusion is due to change in carrier concentration. Okay, so it is due to electric field and it is due to change in carrier concentration. So I can also write a point here. So drift current, drift depends upon electric field and carrier concentration. So carrier concentration. So what does it mean? If electric field is more, drift current is more. If carrier concentration is more, then also drift current is more. Okay. So drift current is only due to electric field, but it can be more if carrier concentration is more. It can be more if electric field is more. So that's why I am saying drift current depends upon, let me write here, drift current depends upon electric field as well as carrier concentration. It is not change in carrier concentration. It is only carrier concentration. If more holes, more drift current. If more electric field, more drift current. Here, if there is only change in carrier concentration, then only there will be diffusion current. So diffusion current is purely due to change in carrier concentration. Drift current is purely due to electric field, but it depends upon also the carrier concentration. Okay. So we will see a question here, one of the previous year question. So drift current depends upon. Now only we have seen. So option A, only the electric field. So it depends upon only the electric field. Option B, carrier concentration. It depends upon carrier concentration. Option C, both electric field and carrier concentration. And carrier concentration. And option D is change in carrier concentration. So now at this point of time, you should be clear about these types of currents. Now only I have discussed about this drift current. Okay. So why am I discussing this question is, so most of the students are misled by this drift current. So for this question, most of the students will choose only this option. So drift current depends upon only the electric field. But this is not true. So drift current depends upon both the electric field and carrier concentration. Now only I have discussed. So it is true that drift current is only due to electric field, but it also depends upon carrier concentration. If carrier concentration is more, obviously drift current is more. If electric field is more, obviously drift current is more. If you have only carrier concentration, if you don't have electric field, you do not get this drift current. So that is the difference. Okay. So thank you so much.